a great way off. He loved me. That's somebody gonna catch on to that. You may be seated in this house. When we were yet a great way off. Oh my God. When we were still not all the way in the church yet. He loved me anyway. When I was yet in my foolishness and my sin, he loved me. Oh my, my, my. God showed compassion towards us. Oh my God, if we look in chapter 15 and we look at verses from the third to the 32nd verse, it is comprised of parables that show that show Jesus' message to be the gospel of the outcast. I mean, realize that he is the gospel to the outcast. Yes, God. Those that have been broken, those who have been hurt, those who have felt like that they don't have nobody. Those that seem like they have been thrown away. Those that seem insignificant or unimportant. I am not talking to anybody in here. As we see in our text this morning, the parable of the lost sheep, the parable of the lost coin, the parable of the lost son, which is our text for the day. How many realize we find the whole chapter telling us in these verses about losing something and finding something. Hey, my name. Can I teach in here anyway? As I look in verse 4 in this text, the key verse in Luke Gospel states, the Son of Man is come to seek and save that which was lost. That was his whole earthly mission, to come and seek and save those that are lost. The three parables in chapter 15 illustrate this purpose of Jesus' earthly mission and reveal God's desire to save the lost for time and eternity. When we learn that seeking lost sinners to bring them to redemption is of utmost importance to the heart of God. Yes, God. Both God in heaven rejoice, oh my mind, with the angels, even when one sinner repents. Do you realize when one person gets saved, how many realize that the angels go up in glory? They start giving God some praise. Ain't gonna find no help in here. That they came to the church that was lost, but they went back another way. Do you realize that heaven rejoicing? God sticks his chest out and smiles because somebody that was lost has been saved. I posted yesterday, win a soul today. That's what it's all about, soul winning. It's not about building funds and all that other funds that you do, but it's talking about somebody being saved. Can I teach you here? So it goes on here. Oh my God, the heavens rejoice. And not amount of sacrifice and suffering is too great in seeking the lost and bringing them to Jesus. No matter what you have to do, sometimes you have to put yourself in the way. Ain't gonna find no heaven here. Share a word with somebody. Live a life that's pleasing to God, that somebody can see the Christ in you. And I'm teaching anyway. As I begin dealing here, oh my God, joy in heaven. If you look at the 7th verse, it's talking about joy in heaven. Oh my God. God and the angels in heaven have such love and compassion and grieve over those who have fallen into sin and spiritual death that when one sinner repents, they openly rejoice. How many realize they shout, oh my God, because somebody got saved. When was the last time you heard some good news that somebody got saved today? We used to sing songs like, I went to a meeting one night and my heart wasn't right. But they said, well, something got a hold on me. Oh, my. How many realize we long for that day when we don't come to church and wait for the pastor to work up a Holy Ghost ladder? But we come looking in expectation for something. Hallelujah. In here, can I teach in here? As I begin to look at the verses in here, how many realize when you lose something, you seek for it? We should pray that the Holy Ghost may fill our hearts with an earnest desire to bring sinners to salvation. That's what we should be doing. We should be praying out to God that somebody be saved. Oh my God, today is a good day for somebody to be saved. Am I doing all right in here? As I deal in here, the woman lost her coin. How many realize you women in here when you lose something? Ain't no rest in the house when nobody else has been there. Right. Until you find what you lost. The woman lost her coin. Yes, it did. The first thing she did was turn a light on. Oh, my. How many know the first thing, step that you need to do when you lost something? Right. You got to find the light on. Turn the light on so you can see clearly. Yeah. My. Sometimes you got to put your glasses on so I'd be able to read my steps that I took. Right. Am I talking all right in here? Yeah. Light a candle. And then she swept her house. How many know once she come to realization that I've lost something in here and I can't see nothing? Then she begins to turn the light on. Then she begins to do what? Sweep. Yeah. Hey, I'm going somewhere. Come go with me. She swept her house, and then you have to seek diligently till you find what was lost. How many know you got to re-step? You got to take some re-steps. Sometimes you got to backtrack and see where you're being, because why? When you used to have joy, when you used to have peace, when you used to come to church and shout, you was ready to come to church, but something has happened. But the first step to salvation is to what? To acknowledge that I got a problem. Yeah. Hey, my. Then I got to sweep around my own front door before I try to sweep around yours. I got to do self-inventory over my own life. I can't blame nobody else for the way I'm acting. Oh, my God, if you ain't done nothing, you'll find no help up in here. It is an individual matter. You got to get to God for yourself. So she had to sweep the house because evidently stuff was dirty and dusty. How many know a dusty Bible leads to a dirty soul? I remember when the last time you picked your Bible up instead of your phone app and begin to read and study God's word and highlight and notate some things about what God done for you. Have you lost something, the joy that I once had? I didn't realize that I got to wait on somebody else to shout now before I shout. But I'm like David this morning. I was just glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. We have lost some things. Hallelujah. She swept her house. Then you have to seek diligently. He that seeketh diligently, ooh, you're going to find it. How many hunger for God? She said diligently, didn't she? She says in our text today, she still have to seek diligently to find what's lost. Yeah. The younger son tells his father to give me what's mine. See, first of all, in their custom, the oldest son got everything. But in our text today, how many know as we summarize the thing, how many realize the parable of the lost sheep? How many realize the Bible tells us in this that, how many realize you can have 100 sheep, but if you lose one sheep, how many realize you're going to find it, you're going to search for it, you ain't going to be satisfied till you find it. Ain't going to find no heaven here. Then it talks about one coin, brother. One coin, lost one coin. She swept the house and cut the light on. How many realize you got to, oh my God, learn how to sweep around your own front door. Yeah. I'm telling everybody up in here, stop talking about they and way they and us and them. Start talking about me, God. I'm the mess. Deliver me from me. Ain't gonna find no help now in here. Woo! Hallelujah here. So the young son said, tell his father, give me, oh my God, what's mine? Ain't the nerve of him. Yeah. He wanted his daddy, I ain't wait till you die, brother. I'm on mine now. Give me what's mine. Yeah. Hallelujah. Here, the youngest son tells him, give me what's mine. He turns all of his assets into hard cash. He went and sold the things that his father gave him. He wanted cash money in his hand. Ain't no fire, no help now. Woo! As we begin to look at this in the parable, the Lord teaches that life of sin and selfishness. Can I teach it here? Oh my God. It is deepest sense in separation from God's love. Only thing that separates us from God is sin. Yeah. Fellowship and authority. The sinner and the backslider, like the young son who pursuing pleasures of sin. Can I teach it here? Woo! my. Waste of physical and intellectual and spiritual gift given by God. He wasted everything. You have a melodious voice, but you won't join the choir. Oh my God, you have gifts and talent and you won't use it for the glory of God. Yeah. Oh my mind, you think you're so wonderful, somebody got to beg you to do something. Baby, bye. No terminology. I mean, your God will raise somebody else up that can't sing and bless them to sing. Ain't got no help in hell. If you be willing and obedient, you can eat the fruit of the land.
Yeah.
You're wasting your time. My. How many realize your spiritual gift? Such waste results in disillusion and sorrow, sometimes degrading personal condition, and always the lack of true and real life that can be found only in the right relationship with God. You can't really live with outside of God. Oh my God, you can have a million bucks and you don't have God, you still ain't got nothing. You can have walls of degrees and walls of accolades, but if you don't have God, you're still empty. Can I teach in here? So it goes on to, when the money was gone, I mean, realize he turned all his assets into hard cash. The brother said, I ain't playing with y'all. I'm for the limit up. How many realize that? But how many realize, remember Moses said he refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. He was willing to suffer the affliction with his people. I'm almost there. Hallelujah here. So he tells us in his text, when the money was gone. I mean, realize when the money is gone, the friends are gone. Ain't got no help now. How many know you have a lot of associates, but when you ain't got nothing else to offer, guess what? I'm like my great nephew now. Guess what? That they gonna be gone because they was only hanging around for the fishes and the loaves. Yes, God in here. So he found himself where? In want. My God, here when the money and material things can't satisfy you. Oh my mind, when you don't have no money, you can't do anything. But how many realize you can be broke as a joker when you got God on your side? How many realize you can be rich and still ain't got nothing because he is everything. My. He joined himself. See, that's what the devil wants you to do. He walked away from his inheritance. He telling his father, Father, give me what's mine. I want everything that belongs to me. I'm taking this. And how many know, but it didn't have no value to you. Just like some of the children, mama and daddy, worked hard for their land, their property, and stuff. And soon as they need some cash, how many know they'll sell out the stuff you work for? Baby, you gotta learn how to live while you're living, because when you die, your stuff gonna go missing because of am I teaching already here? Yeah. He joined himself with the world. He done the things that they were doing. He walked away from the church. He walked away from God. He started going along to get along. He started wanting some friends. Oh my God. He wanted somebody. He had to pay for some friends. I ain't got no help in here. Now when the money was gone, he found himself all by himself. Hey, my. He didn't. And not only that, but he found himself in a hog pen. And good God Almighty, he found himself, oh my God, eating those things that the hog ate. The things that detest us. How many know the late Angelo used to say, the devil will hire you on broken promises. And he'll pay you off in disappointment. He'll promise you a mansion. But he'll give you a shack, oh my God, way down the way. You got to watch the setups of the devil. So the young man found himself eating in the mud, in the mire. How many know that was sin or drag you through some stuff? How many know that sin will dirty you up? How many know sin will use you up? Sin will make you stink. Sin will make you nasty. Sin will take you lower than you ever wanted to go. That was sin done. And you find yourself, you'll wake up one day in a hog pen, eating what hogs ate. You was feeling detested. He defiled himself with the things that destroy. If anybody ever self-sabotage yourself, find yourself back where you said you wouldn't go, you find yourself so low. He brought the shame of his father's house. He brought shame upon the church. He's gone back into the world, doing what the world is doing. But the Bible says, train up a child in the way he shall go. And when he is old, he won't depart from it. I don't care how far your children walk away. I don't care how far they go away. They might be doing some things that's not lawful to do. But you got to have a little talk with Jesus. You got to tell him all about your trouble. And he will answer prayer. In the way they should go. And when they get old, they won't depart from it. That don't mean they're going to not make mistakes. That don't mean they're going to go out in the world and bring shame to your name. The hurt from a wayward child, a wayward son, and a wayward daughter keep you up all night on your knees praying. Your children has rejected you. Your children have left you. Your children is calling you pain. It's not a stranger. It's not the enemy. But it's those that are in your own house. It's your kinfolk them that keep acting up on you. But I heard an old song say, trouble in my way. I have to cry something. But that's all right. His father, he's gone back into the world. He's bringing shame on the family. But when you come to yourself, I heard the big word, when means all door. And during that time, when he came to himself, he remembered how good God was. It reminded me of the story of the young woman who said, Lord, I'm going to backslide. I'm going to go back into the world. It's hard over here. But before I go, I just want to write down some things to thank you for. Thank you for providing for me. Thank you for healing me. Thank you for picking me up. Thank you for making a way. Messed up. Yeah. that's in this house today, and everybody that's on Facebook, having a short man just like me, oh God, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But I found a way out. What's in name? He was standing in stuff at the test. And he said, I got to go home. Is there anybody listening to me today? You've been in the hall pen. Come on home. Come on home. Never mind the sin you done. Never mind how you stayed at home. Never mind how you told them lies. Never mind what you've been into. Come is your home on the altar. And your sacrifice has been made. Your heart, the spirit control. Friend of mine, you need a pen. Lord, I'm on my way home. Yeah, 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 yeah. He said, I'm on my way home. Sister Stephanie, he got out of the hall pen. He's on his way home, but he wasn't there yet. The text says, when I was yet a great way off, I wasn't in the church yet, but I was thinking about going back to church. I was thinking about rededicating my life to Christ. But while one foot was in the world, the other was headed back home. He saw me, say yeah, God. He saw his son, and he got excited. Come on and holly and hear that. When I was still alone, way off, he loved me. No greater love than this, for he would lay down his life for a friend. Say yeah, yeah. The Apostle Paul says, peradventure, for a good man, one would even tempt to die. Peradventure, for a righteous man, one would even try to die. But you weren't good, neither were you righteous. But Jesus, he died for you. Jesus committed his love toward you. While you were yet a sinner, he died for you. But I'm on my way home. He was walking home. His daddy almost stressed out. And I heard my Baptist brother say, I came to Jesus just as I was, weary, wounded, and sad. I found in him a resting place, and it sure done made me glad. Any backsliders in the house who has been reclaimed? And I know that God brought you back. When I was far off, when he got there, this is what I'm going to say when I go back to church. I'm going to say, Pastor, I want you to forgive me. Members, I want you to forgive me. God, I want you to forgive me. But how many know the process of redemption started when he started walking home? But when he got there, Brother Green, his daddy was trying to hear that. His daddy said, Lord, put his arms around him. Can't no nobody rock you like you. Can't nobody rub you like you. Can't nobody pick you up like you. When he fell in his father's lap and he rubbed that head, he said, Father, I have sinned against you. I have sinned against heaven. But he said, Son, don't worry about that. Come on, y'all. Kill the fattest cat. Come on and put some shoes on it. Put a new dress on it. I moved from my old house. And I moved to a new house. I have become a new creation. In Christ Jesus, open the pastoral way. And behold. He told him, kill the fattest cat. And under her life, he said, let us celebrate. Because my son once was lost. And now he is found. Amazing.